Just receiving his bell, the first rider in this IRT jumping grand final, Merrick Eubank and Alan Tinas. Valentina's just approaching the first fence now. Tall Vertical, sponsored by IRT, International Racehorse Transport. Valentina's is by very well-known show jumping sire, Alamo. As expected, that is a tough line down there from the triple bar. Four very short strides, that tall South Australian Tourism Commission Vertical. No problem for Merrick and Alantinas through the vertical down to that 1.44 Oxer at fence 5. Clear over the Atco fence. And the barn doors jumping this course very well so far. Coming up to the tough section. Treble combination, two strides over that big Oxer, one stride over a tall vertical out. Now to the Olympic Trailers Oxer fence, easily there for Alantinas. Here we are over the 1.60 wall at 11. It's a big fence, big imposing fence. No trouble there for Alantinas. He's still clear. To 12A and B. No trouble there over 13. That's a clear round for... Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's a clear round there for our trailblazer in this IRT jumping grand final. No trouble on the course for Merrick Eubank and Alan Teen. It's clear on jumping and clear on time. As I said, we have 19 starters in this class and just receiving the bell. This is our second rider. This is Mark Lind. Mark is from Mount Barker in South Australia, a local rider. Mark rides a six-pack. Mark had a two fences down yesterday in the warm-up class here. Nine penalties in that class, but he's clear so far over the first three fences. Just touches with a back leg, that big Oxer at number 5. As John said, it's 1.65 wide, so it's a big wide fence. No trouble there over the Atco wall. Atco, great supporters of the Australian International 3-day event. It is the Atco show jumping day. Comes down to this tough line. There's a plank down at fence 8. Very tall vertical fence. No trouble into the treble combination and out. Spooks around that South Australian Tourism Commission. Vertical there, that third fence. Here he is to the wall. Fortunately, just gets a little bit caught up on his approach between fence 10 and 11. Unfortunate refusal there for Mark Lind and six-pack at fence 11, the wall. It's up nice and high over it the second time. Just the two fences to go for Mark Lind and six-pack. Easy in through the combination. So we have had the front rail down at 12A, so that is, we'll just wait for official confirmation. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is 16 jumping penalties for Mark Lind and Six Pack in a time of 109.61. Just waiting for official confirmation on the score there for Mark Lind and Six Pack. We move on. We have our third rider into the ring. He had a great afternoon yesterday in the IRT jumping warm-up class. This is James Arkins and Ross Waite Vigilante the second. As I said, James had a good afternoon yesterday. Running second on Ross Waite Vigilante, the second in that warm-up class. So he's had a great start to his weekend here in this grand final competition. Definitely enjoying the Adelaide sunshine so far. Beautiful day here for equestrian sport. Ross Waite Vigilante the second. It's by Voltaire too, and out of a super imposing mare. Start carrying the four penalties in so far. No trouble in over fence eight. Rubs the vertical into the combination, the treble combination. But they stab and he just remains with that. Four penalties coming down to what has proved to be a tough fence already. This fence 11, the wall. Mark Lynn having a little bit of trouble with it just earlier. Clear in over fence 12, A and B, and the last. Good round there for James Arkins and Ross Waite Vigilante. Comes in as one of the favourites in this competition. Four penalties to add for jumping. Clear on time for James Arkins and Ross Waite Vigilante the second. Well, next into the arena, a man that needs very little introduction to anyone that is a student of equestrian sport in Australia. Just receiving his bell is Chris Chug and Sierra Casiago. This grey stallion is only an 8-year-old. He's had some great performances this year in, including a second in the Gatton World Cup and a first at the Caboolture World Cup in 2015. He was also the winner yesterday in our IRT jumping warm-up class. Next into the ring, Chris Chug and Sierra Casiago. Interesting there, Chris Chug just letting the time run down. He actually started 6 seconds after the clock had already run down. Clear through the first four fences for Chris Chug. Had a great round yesterday. In our warm-up class, lovely, clear, nice and quick. Easy win there for him yesterday. As I said, he's got some great form. He's had not only that first at Caboolture World Cup, but also first at Gawler and recently at Adelaide in the World Cup. So certainly he's enjoying his trips to South Australia this year. Notice that big green disc on him, on Casiago's breastplate there, just indicating that he is a stallion. And Chris says that he is also standing at stud this season, so very busy horse. Fortunate four penalties down there for the rail at 12A. So that is four penalties for Chris Chugg and Sierra Casiago for the rail there at fence 12A. Inside the time, puts him in second position. So it was interesting to see Chris Chugg just starting a little later than expected by the time he got through the start flags there. But his time is fine. So four penalties to add for Chris Chugg and Sierra Casiago. Well, ladies and gentlemen, next into the ring in this IRT jumping grand final. This is Jack and Christy Brune. It's an Irish sport horse cross by Family Ties. Christy said he's a quirky horse who does like to buck on occasion. Christy Brune and Jack.
Lovely over the IRT fence. Our starting fence there today, and also huge supporters of equestrian sport around Australia. Great people to deal with, whether you're sending horses into or out of Australia, or indeed anywhere around the world.
Christy and Jack had a clear round yesterday in our warm-up class here, finishing sixth in that class with a good quick time and that clear round. No trouble for her so far in this IRT jumping grand final. No trouble over the planks at eight. This big treble, there's a rail down at 9B. She's clear out. Little rattle on the front rail there on 10. It stays up. Gave that wall a big thump, but the block has stayed on amazingly. Just hung on by a thread.
Well, the rail down there for Christy Brune and Jack at fence 9B. Gave that wall a tickle too, but it just held on, that block. Puff of wind extra and it might have fallen off, but she has just the four penalties to add to her score. So we have in the lead at the moment. It remains our first rider out today. That was Merrick Eubank and Alan Tinas. Followed by Chris Chugg and Casiago and James Arkins and Ross Waite Vigilante. But next into the ring, we have Madison Stephen and Yolambi's Carmen. Madison travelling over from WA. She's coached by David Dobson, who's also competing in this class with two horses. Yolambi's Carmen, Madison Stephen.
No trouble with the first three fences for Yolambi's Carmen. Started the course riding pretty well so far. Lovely over that big wide oxer at fence five. He's John Valance told us earlier, it's not the biggest fence on course in terms of height, but it's very wide. Also got the water tray under it to add a little bit more degree of difficulty to it. Planks at fence 8 are proving to be a little tricky today. Also has the back rail at 9B. Treble combinations always more difficult, particularly when they're up here around about the meter 60 mark. Lovely over the wall there at fence 11. And as John Valance told us earlier, that is a genuine meter 60 fence. The rail down there at 12A.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was Madison Stephen and Yolambi's Carmen, and the score in for her, that is 12 jumping penalties to add, three rails down there. Rails at 8, 9B and 12A. Which after our first six riders, we see that Merrick Eubank and Alantinus, they're our first rider out in this IRT jumping grand final. And they remain in the lead with the only clear round so far. We've got 3-4 folders. Just the one clear so far. Just receiving their bell. This is coach of Madison Stephen, David Dobson, and Oaks Zena.
Oxina had two fences down in the warm-up class for this yesterday evening. Looking good early in the course here, though. Clear through the first five fences. Jumping well. This mare by Warlord 2. David says she's got a lovely personality. You can really see it from the way she travels around this course. Lovely looking mare. Very talented. Fortunate rail down there at 9B there for David Dobson. Gives him four penalties so far. He's got the combination and the final fence to go. As we know, David Dobson, he doesn't travel out of Western Australia unless he thinks he's going to win, so you're hanging in there if he can keep his four penalties.
Well, just the four penalties there for David Dobson in this lovely mare, Oaks Zena. Rail down there in the treble at 9B. Gives him four penalties, clear inside the time though. And he adds to our growing list of four falters in this IRT jumping grand final class. Next out, and they will be receiving their bell very shortly. There it is from our judge, Sue Ryan. This is Stephanie Tucker. Riding Oaks Redwood. Stephanie, another Western Australian. They've travelled over here en masse. She's from Dalkeith in WA. And again, is also coached by David Dobson.
Stephanie was a winner of the WA State Championships in 2014 and 2015. Interesting jump there over the triple bar. easily down that four stride line to the big South Australian Tourism Commission vertical. Four penalties there for the rail down the ATCO fence. She carries in four. No trouble with the big blue planks there at eight. And unfortunately that fall.
Well, very unfortunate fall there for Stephanie Tucker and Oaks Redwood. That is elimination from this IRT jumping grand final class. Very tough combination there through 9A, B and C for the treble. So while the ground crew quickly rebuild that fence and replace that rail. Good to see Stephanie on her feet and Oaks Redwood looking all fine. Next into the ring, we are watching Clint Beresford and Emmaville Jitterbug. Clint's from Bega in New South Wales. He's coached by very well-known jumping rider Grant Hughes. He's a winner at the Future Stars Final at SIAC in 2013. And the overall Young Rider Championship also in his great year of 2013. That was at Sydney Royal. And then in 2014, back at Sydney Royal, he was the winner of the overall Section 3. Just about to begin their round. This is the 23-year-old from Bega in New South Wales, Clint Beresford, and Emmaville Jitterbug.
Fortunate rail there for Clint at fence three, the South Australian Tourism Commission vertical. So he's carrying four faults. No trouble through fences four and five, or six, the ATCO fence. So far, we've still got just the one clear round, and that is Merrick Eubank and Alan Tinas. No trouble over fence seven. The big planks at eight. It's a bit keen down into the treble. There's a rail down there in both the A and C elements of that treble at fence nine. And there's another disobedience at that big wall, to meter 60 wall at fence 11. We saw it early in the class from Mark Lind also having a refusal there. Clint electing that discretion is a better part of valor today and has decided to retire.
So after rails down at fences 3, 9, A and C, and then the refusal at the wall at fence 11, Clint Barrison and Emmerville Jitterbug elect to retire from this IRT jumping grand final class. Which brings into the ring our next rider. This is Jeffrey Bloomfield. And he rides Pilots. Jeff, very, very well known, very experienced jumping rider. Representing Australia at the Sydney Olympic Games in 2000. And also World Equestrian Games in Spain in 2002 and in 1998 at Rome. Riding the horse that he bred himself, this is Jeff Bloomfield and Pilot.
Pilot, Saint-Francais, breeding. It's only been competed lightly in the last few seasons, Pilot, but has placed in all his classes at the South Australian Championships over the last 2 years. There's rail down at the ATCO fence at number 6, so that's 4 faults to add to his score. Plus another 4 for the rail down, the front rail down there at fence 7. Four at 9A. So far, Jeff Bloomfield and Pilot carrying 12 faults. No trouble over that tough wall there at 11. Easy through 12 A and B. Unfortunate rail.
Well, unfortunate rail at the final fence there for Jeff Bloomfield and Pilot. After rails at fences 6, 7 and 9 A, that brings his total to 16 faults in this IRT jumping grand final class. That was Jeff Bloomfield and Pilot. So we still just have the one clear round, and that was our first rider out, Merrick Eubank, Alan Tinas. We've got 4 faulters, David Dobson and Oak Zena, Chris Chug, James Arkins and Christy Bruin. We move on quickly to Jeff Evans. Well, Fieldbrook, Carunia and Jeff Evans finished with a total of 12 faults for rails down at fences 3, 9A and 9B. That treble at 9 proving very difficult in this IRT jumping grand final class. Course designer John Valance told us earlier that he thought that treble would be tough. It is proving that way, with still just the one clear round. But next into the ring we have Brooke Dobbin from Victoria, and he rides Silvo. Brooke and Silvo had a very good afternoon in here yesterday. Clear round in the warm-up class for this. So coming in on form. And also had first in the Glenhaven Park Grand Prix and fifth just recently in the World Cup at the Showcase of Show Jumping up in Sydney. This is Brooke Dobbin and Silvo.
No trouble there for Brooke and Silvo. Over fence one, as I said, Brooke from Yarra Glen in Victoria. Been show jumping for a long time at the high level. Previous winner of the World Cup League in 2011. Also won the meter 60 Grand Prix at Hickstead. Not an easy thing to do. Been selected for Australia very many times on Victorian teams. Lovely gelding, Silvo, owned by Angela Cooney. Having no trouble around this course so far. Lovely through the treble combination. Still clear to through the first 9 fences of this 13 fence. IRT jumping grand final course. Just the combination at 12 and the last fence at 13 to go. Unfortunate rail down there for Jeff at 12A.
Well, it was looking like such a good round, but unfortunately, rail down there for Brooke Dobbin and Silvo at fence 12A, third to last fence. Very disappointing. He joins that growing list of riders sitting on 4 faults. Still just the one clear round after our first dozen riders. That is Merrick Eubank and Alan Tinas. You remember him, he was the first rider to go in this IRT jumping grand final class. But we move on quickly. And receiving their bell for the second time in this class. This is Quality Euro, ridden by James Arkins.
We said earlier that James had a fantastic afternoon here yesterday in the warm-up class, and he did take home some prize money courtesy of IRT. He was second on his previous ride, Ross Waite Vigilante. This horse that he's on now, Quality Euro, ran third. Both jumping clear rounds there, so he comes in great form. Really enjoys his trip to Adelaide. He's from Southern Highlands in the New South Wales, James, but he's been on form. Extremely competitive. Developing a very strong team of horses. You know, he's already in the mix in this competition with his previous ride, just the 4 faults on Ross Waite Vigilante. Gets in nice and deep to the wall at fence 11. Won't worry James though, he's a very brave rider. Little rattle over that tough fence at 12A.
Well, there we go, ladies and gentlemen. I feel good. Derek Eubank was feeling a little lonely. There's the only clear round there, but we have another to add. That is no faults for James Arkins and quality Euro. Time of 88.04. A little bit quicker than the time of Merrick Eubank. So we now have two riders on clear rounds in this IRT jumping grand final class. And also returning to the arena for his second ride. This is Chris Chug and Crystalline.
Well, Chris, he's got a young team of horses. He's only a 7-year-old mare. Mike Cristallo won. Lovely mare to handle, this one. And also, again, very, very good jumper. Only young to be competing in this World Cup level. An unfortunate rail down yesterday in the warm-up class. Chris really chasing the time. Made a rare mistake. But he is looking on form today in this beautiful Adelaide afternoon. No trouble there for Chris Chug and Crystalline through the big fences at 10 and 11. Here he is, has a 4-12A, unfortunately.
Well, that is four jumping penalties for Chris Chug and Crystalline for the rail down there. And what's proving to be a very tough combination towards the end of this IRT jumping course. Chris, a 5-time Australian senior show jumping champion and also a representative of Australia at the World Equestrian Games in Kentucky in 2010, riding the beautiful Vivant. This is Christy Brune and Harbati. So yeah, we can confirm this is Christy Brune and Harbati. Hey. Christy back out here for her second ride in this IRT jumping grand final class. Christy from Mount Gambier in South Australia, approaching the first fence.
Apologies for the confusion there. We missed Caitlin Bolger and Danza Star. Christy not missing the opportunity to ride a second time in this magnificent ATCO main arena here at the Australian International 3-day event. Great exhibition of equestrian sport, bringing highest level of eventing and jumping together. Christy and Harbati just having the four faults, for the rail at fence 6 also. Ooh. so far. Christy carrying 16 faults. Three rails and the circle there before 9A. Oh, big jump over fence 11. Heart in the mouth moment when you're a rider, but no trouble there. She was clear over it. Rail there at 12B. That's been a difficult combination all afternoon.
So for Christy Brune and Harbarty, she had four rails down plus the circle before fence 9A and two time penalties as well. So a total of 22 faults for Christy Brune and Harbarty. Well, we're down to the last three riders in this IRT jumping grand final class. And just taking in the atmosphere in this beautiful ATCO main arena. This is Stephen Hill and Yolambi's Bellini Star. Stephen's from Roses Lane in Victoria. He's coached by Australian representative Jamie Coman. Stephen's had a great year so far. He's a bit of a latecomer to riding, but he's very much made up for it. Runner-up Australian senior champion at the Australian titles in 2015. Stephen Hill and Yolambi's Bellini Star. Yolambi's Bellini Star by that very well-known Australian jump horse, Conquistador. Another mare. Good representation of mares in this World Cup class here today. As he said, he has been in a very, very good form, Stephen. This combination. Also winning the World Cup class at Melbourne Royal this year. Looking good through the first nine fences in this 13 fence World Cup course designed by John Vallance. Still just got the two clear rounds on the scoreboard. We will of course be returning with second round of this World Cup. Well, there we go, ladies and gentlemen. That is another clear round, and that is Stephen Hill and Yolambi's Bellini Star. Clear round inside the time. So we now have three clears in this IRT jumping grand final class. Turning out to be a very exciting afternoon here of World Cup jumping. As we see, returning to the arena, David Dobson from Western Australia. It's a busy man with his two rides in this class and also number of students competing alongside him. David, this time riding Concord Ego Z.
Concord Ego Z, another of the stallions competing in this class. So really has been a mix here today of geldings, stallions and mares. Concord Ego Z by Calvaro. The second in the Western Australian State Championships World Cup class. As we said earlier, David is a very competitive jumping rider. Wouldn't have come all the way to South Australia if he didn't think he had a good shot of winning this IRT jumping grand final class. He's looking good so far. Clear through the first nine fences. Previous grand final winner, David. Lovely fence over 11. It's a big wall. And a couple of issues there today. No trouble through 12A and B. Can he jump clear over the last? That is another clear round. Well, clear on jumping. Unfortunately, one time penalty there for David Dobson and Concord Ego Z. So we still have our three zero falters. The James Arkins on quality Euro, Merrick Eubank and Alan Tinas. And just recently, Stephen Hill and Yolambi's Bellini star. But we can add on one time penalty. David Dobson and Concord Ego Z. We're now down to the last rider in this IRT jumping a grand final class. He's already been out in this arena. But this is Clint Beresford and S.L. Donato. No trouble through the first three fences for Clint Beresford, S.L. Donato. Lovely grey by Daly Kay. Only an 8-year-old, one of the younger horses in this class. Clint, 23-year-old from Bega. He's a farrier by trade. One of Australia's up and coming jumping superstars. Unfortunate four penalties there at fence 9B for Clint and S.L. Donato. Very big jump over the wall at 11. Lovely jumping horse, as many Daly K horses are. Carrying the distinctive grey colour. Rail down there for Clint, also at 12B. So for Clint Beresford and S.L. Donato, that is 8 faults. Clear inside the time though. We'll wait to see whether Clint gets to return for the second round of this IRT jumping grand final. We will be taking 10 riders. 10 riders, it is confirmed, our top 10 into the second round of the IRT jumping. But we certainly know that our clear rounds of James Arkins and Quality Euro, Merrick Eubank and Alan Tinas, and Stephen Hill and Yolambi's Bellini star. We'll be dueling it out in the second round of this very exciting IRT jumping grand final. It is a World Cup held here at the Australian International 3-day event.